So if we can really take two steps forward, then I think if the people are at the back, they can also have a clear sight. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of His Excellency Mr. Mohammad Ziauddin, the Ambassador of Bangladesh to USA, and all the proud members of Bangladesh Armed Forces and Bangladesh Embassy in Washington, D.C., let me take this distinct honor to extend a warm welcome to you all in this charming winter evening. In this great occasion, I would like to let you know that the people of Bangladesh have had made countless sacrifices over generations in endless pursuit of freedom. For them, independence has been an article of faith, which is deeply ingrained in their national psyche. However, the year 1971 saw Bangladesh in their finest glory. Although, to earn that glory of freedom, innumerable people embraced martyrdom. And the year also saw unthinkable acts of sacrifice, valor, and courage, as well as meticulous military planning. The history of the military of Bangladesh began its inception right from the day one of our liberation war. With the clarion call from our father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, it started its journey on the 9th of 25th March 1971 in Chittagong, one of the major cities of erstwhile Pakistan. On that day, they revolted against the Pakistani forces and joined their hands with the general mass of the country and contributed immensely in the quest for freedom. Later on 4th April 1971, after about 8 months of the beginning of liberation war, the newly formed Bangladesh government felt the necessity of having a regular armed forces, which was essential for our independence. And on 21st November 1971, Bangladesh Armed Forces comprising Army, Navy, and Air Force came into being and launched an all-out offensive to expedite our liberation. Since then, the Armed Forces has become the symbol of courage and valor for the entire nation and earned a permanent position in the hearts and minds of each Bangladeshi for their dedicated professional commitment to the nation. Today, I recall those members of the armed forces and other freedom fighters without whose supreme sacrifices I would not have proudly proclaimed us as Bangladeshi. May the Almighty grant them their prizes in their life hereafter. In the same token, let me also recall our friends who stood beside us during our liberation war. With the passage of time, the armed forces has grown bigger and efficient. Present government, under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, has taken keen interest to modernize the armed forces to meet both traditional and non-traditional security threats and participate actively in global peace effort. Today, standing tall and proud, I can say that Bangladesh Armed Forces has earned its reputation as modern and professional military at home and abroad. Alone, we have not come this far. Our friends from across the world have supported us throughout our journey. And in that, the unconditional support and cooperation of the United States cannot be overemphasized. Our wholehearted gratitude to the United States government, its military, and our people for all that they have done to us. May the Almighty give us enough strength and opportunity to prosper further together. Distinguished guests, we are once again beholden to all of you for being with us this evening to celebrate this great occasion. I'm extremely happy to make our well wishers from the Corps of Attache, our beloved Bangladeshi diaspora, and proud contributors of Bangladesh Armed Forces, present and retired. Your presence in today's event is the testimony of your unfathomable care and love for Bangladesh, its people, and for the armed forces. I must make a special mention about the presence of tonight's guest of honor, Lieutenant General Gina Gross, the Deputy Chief of Staff of the US Air Force. Sir, your elegant presence has added an extra ornament to our program today. I'd also like to thank your husband, Mr. Brian, to take part in this event and to grace this occasion. We are also privileged and honored to have with us the Foreign Secretary of Bangladesh, Mr. Mohammad Shahidul Haq, sir. Sir, somewhere? Yes, sir is there. Thank you very much, sir. And thank you very much for your kind presence. We are really honored. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you once again for joining us this evening and thanking and making us so proud. We are really touched. May I now request our respected ambassador, Mr. Ziauddin, to come over and make his remarks. Thank you very much.
Steps forward. Gina Gross, the Foreign Secretary of the People's Republic of Bangladesh, Mr. Mohammad Shahidul Haq, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good evening. I have great pleasure in welcoming you all to the Bangladesh Embassy this evening. I thank all of you, especially our chief guest, Lieutenant General Gina Gross, for being with us this evening to celebrate one of the glorious and historic days of our nation, the Armed Forces Day. On this occasion, I recall our glorious liberation war when our people and men in uniforms fought as one for our freedom and independence. The Bangladesh Armed Forces represent a great legacy of sacrifice and patriotism. Their heroics and those of our freedom fighters, especially those who laid down their lives, have inspired succeeding generations in contributing towards a happy and prosperous Bangladesh, as envisioned by the father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. On this day, with much humility, I pay homage to those valiant martyrs and extend deepest condolences to their families and friends. Bangladesh is proud of its armed forces. Their sacrifice and contributions during the War of Liberation have simply been invaluable. And now, in times of natural calamities, they have become indispensable for their humanitarian services, which include relief to and rehabilitation of the distressed. Our people deeply appreciate and are grateful to them for their sacrifices and services. Indeed, our men and women in uniform are an important part of our nation, and the armed forces an important institution. Our armed forces have also some unique achievements. They have prepared and distributed identity cards to all of our 160 million people and completed the sensitive voters list, which is very, very important for all national elections. They are currently preparing issuance of international passports and the national smart cards for all Bangladeshi citizens. The armed forces are also involved in the critical matters of internal and external security, countering terrorism and extremism, combating smuggling and human trafficking and drug trafficking, as well as supporting the civil administration in conducting their jobs in times of crisis. Blue helmets in 13 countries, Bangladesh is today one of the top troop contributing countries in the world. Till now, Bangladesh troops have served in 39 war-ravaged countries and in 54 missions. of them, 131 of our valiant peacekeepers gave their lives for the cause of international peace and security. Today, Bangladesh is a brand name in the United Nations peace support operation. Through participation in United Nations peacekeeping missions, our armed forces have earned worldwide reputation as dedicated, committed, efficient professionals. Their good image as peacekeepers is because of their respect for the religious, cultural, and social values of the peoples in the countries they are called upon to serve. While in the United Nations missions, they continue helping preparing democratic elections, establishment of democracy, infrastructure, education, healthcare, and development activities. In Bangladesh, the government led by Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, who is also the Defense Minister, is modernizing the armed forces. Our effort is supported by the United States government. Due to the confluence of the work agenda and priorities, the cooperation between the two countries got a significant boost. Bangladesh thanks the United States for its technical assistance in setting up GIPSOC and making it into a globally reputed institute for training peacekeepers. This has greatly helped Bangladesh to meet its requirements. As a country with fully equipped prepared, the United States has also provided Bangladesh with hardware assistance, leadership development, information sharing, and military training to develop our armed forces' professionalism, now recognized the world over. Our government is keen to have this cooperation flourish further. Recent reflection of our collaboration has been the installation of automated identification system to enhance the capacity of the maritime security sector of Bangladesh. Besides, during this year, the two countries held the annual security dialogue. In addition, the two countries participated in the Hallmark Multinational Disaster Response Exercise and Exchange, and also in the Joint Navy Exercise Cooperation Afloat Readiness and Training. All these took place in Bangladesh with great success this year. Then again, in December of this year, the military-to-military dialogue is scheduled to take place in Hawaii. This will provide the opportunity to the delegations of both the countries to look at the minute details of cooperation. We hope this professional exchange will continue, particularly in the pertinent areas of security, strategic, and development issues. Regular discussions in these areas would surely contribute to better understanding and cooperation between our two important institutions. I wish to conclude here by emphasizing the fact that today Bangladesh and USA enjoys the best of relations. It is our hope and desire that this relationship would continue and sustain to reach greater heights. Long live US-Bangladesh friendship. Once again, I thank you all for gracing this occasion with your valuable presence and for joining us this evening in our Armed Forces Day celebrations. I thank you all very much.
Thank you, Excellency, for your valuable comments. Dear audience, now I'd like to welcome our guest of honor for this evening, Lieutenant General Gina Gross, and she will be making her remarks. As I invite her to the podium, let me have the honor of introducing her. She is a remarkable person. She is the Deputy Chief of Personnel Management. Prior to her current assignment, she was the Director of the Air Force Sexual Assault Prevention and Response Office of the Vice Chief of Staff. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear from Lieutenant General Gina Gross.
Thank you. We in the United States also celebrate our Armed Forces Day in November and really reflect on those that have served so that we enjoy the freedoms that we have. So I think it's just one of many things we have in common with our country. The Air Force Chief of Staff, my boss, General Goldfein, asked me to pass along to you his sincere thanks for the support your armed forces are providing to the United States, and he looks forward to a long and fruitful relationship between our air forces. And my husband and I had the great privilege of meeting your Air Force Chief of Staff last year at the former Chief of Staff's house, and we very much enjoyed his conversation, and my husband happens to be a C-130 pilot, so we had a great discussion about how your Air Force uses C-130s. The bilateral relationship between our two nations, the United States and Bangladesh, is growing, and it is the partnership between our air forces. The United States and Bangladesh, we have many shared interests. I want to assure you that the United States Air Force is here for you. We are proud of our growing military partnerships with the Bangladesh Air Force. We have partnered together during exercises like Hope South and Pacific Angel, which provide opportunities to strengthen interoperability and capacity. We share a strong relationship with the Bangladesh Air Force through the National Guard Bureau's State Partnership Program. Since 2008, the Oregon National Guard and the Bangladesh Armed Forces have been partners in the State Partnership Program. This program provides opportunities for military-to-military engagements where soldiers and airmen exchange ideas and best practices, participate in exercises, and form lasting relationships. We are also building strong personal relationships through annual airman-to-airman talks, which began in 2015. Additionally, one of your airmen is attending our Air Command and Staff College this year, so we're very excited to have him here. Leadership your armed forces has shown on the world stage, which you so eloquently discussed. During the devastating earthquake that struck Nepal in 2015, Bangladesh was one of the military regional partners that leveraged your air power capabilities to provide humanitarian response. You are a leading net contributor to UN peacekeeping operations throughout the world. They shared with me today that you were also one of the first countries that offered to help the United States when we suffered that terrible flooding in New Orleans from Katrina. So just one more example of your tremendous work around the nation helping people in need. Successful partnerships rely on strong relationships, and that certainly can be said of our military-to-military relationship. Many of you in this room have played an integral part in this endeavor, and we will continue to do that. So I would end on the same note that you did. Let's continue a wonderful friendship and partnership with Bangladesh.
Salute, action, yowza.